Hello!
Welcome. Now, every time someone mentions this beer to me, I picture one film. I try to remember what it was just before we came across a few jars of ales and ciders. It was the River Wild.
I thought you were going to say the Kevin Bacon film where, you know, in a...
Kevin Bacon?
Oh, there you go.
Kevin Bacon and Meryl Streep. He's talking about it's a Disney film, I think. Is it a Disney film? I'm not sure. And it's basically where people travel down the rapids of the river. And as you can see, you got bears, you got fish.
Double hopped pale ale.
I've had it. I've had it on cask. I wasn't too keen if I'm but Andrew purchased it. I think it was a supermarket buy, maybe.
I think so. I think either Sainsbury's or maybe like Booze or something. Or probably Sainsbury's, I'd say, because they do a lot of fillers.
A double hop pale ale. I like the artwork on this bit though.
I saw this and I thought, whoa, Fuller's. And then the second thought, Wild River. I thought, it's a new beer. Then it says double hop. I went, oh, even better.
The new style bottles as well.
Yeah.
Because the original bottles was what every other brewery uses.
Mm.
The new style bottles is a lot slimmer, a lot more trim. You get a little more artwork on some of the new labels as well. It's been in the cellar for a while, though, hasn't it?
Yeah. Just we've been meaning to try it, but just like, you know.
Yeah, we've had beers. I mean, last year we purchased so many beers.
Mm.
We're still drinking them, and that was in May 2013, and now it's February, and we're still drinking them.
Yeah, so.
We purchased like over 300 to 400 bottles.
So I think we're close to like finishing up, but also maybe like ready for a little new stuff.
Slight lemon, little bit of hoppiness there. I do like the new logo as well. Because the new logo.
Oh, the Griffin.
Yeah.
It's actually the Griffin Brewery, and the Fullers is just like a business name.
Yeah. I mean, a lot of corporations have like a fancy name to sell the beers.
Play sharp. You got sort of get that what like river water feel, don't you? Like
you get a strong caramel pine backbone. Mm. We've had a lot of hoppy beers earlier today.
And it's like
Five Towns
flushing water at you, I mean, like a river. You know what I mean? That's understand why. They've gone with that name.
It has got that stagnant water though aroma.
Maybe because of being stood, you know what I mean?
Might be that, but do you know when you stand above a big vat of water, you get that stagnant aroma smell. But it does. Mm. It's very. Yeah,
it's lovely that way.
It's 4.5. It is about the session level.
Double locked as well. It's coming quite dry as well. And zesty. Well, it says here, it's
has that polished feel, though, doesn't it? We had some really hopped beers earlier from Five Towns, and it gives that rough edge. It's like it needs a little work.
Mm.
Whereas this, it gives the same presence, but it gives that polished feel. You know what I mean? It's like you get that same power, but it's like polished off. It's like smooth edges and stuff.
I almost get as if you got hops coming at you like that. Boom, boom.
Yeah, you get the hops, but it's more like a sharpened bullet.
Yeah.
Rather than what we had earlier from Five Towns, it was like 500 bullets. Like the anime. It's like bullets. But you get all those bullets. Whereas this, it's got lesser bullets, but it's got same impact.
What do you mean, like Alchemist? Is it? Or, you know,
the week when we had the Alchemist.
Not me deal.
Yeah. But yeah, this has got like a sharpened, refined, double hopped taste.
And it's a more sessionable ale as well. So you could enjoy that. It'll keep you well refreshed.
I have to confess, this is a lot better than the cask version I had.
Yeah.
The cask version was a little weak, a little bit of all over the place. The bottled version is lit more. I mean, we've seen beers like Marble Brewery and the Earl Grey IPA, whereas it was a lot better in bottle than it was on cask, remember? And when we were on keg, it's the same. It's an unfiltered beer, as you can see. Andrew's face. Oh.
Hello!
Slight lemony. Again,
oh, you get that nice freshness to it. You know what I mean? Sort of like
it has that like zest of lime as well.
It's sort of like the pleasant sort of feel that you would do when you get when you approach a river, or sort of like nice freshness to it.
I mean, when you again with the fish thing there, if you do a sprite of what time, give it a spread of time.
It's a bit smooth, nice and tasty.
Again, you get offset and mint, but I don't know if that's because of the freshness from the chilled to the temperature.
Yeah.
Because then we get that temperature. But this is really nice beer. I actually prefer it now more from the bottle than I had it from the cask.
It's a bit like Saltaire when you... And they sometimes have beers that are sometimes better than on bottle.
Or
that start espresso stout. If you get that on the cask, it's too smooth. Whereas if you get it on bottle, you've got more the sharp espresso taste.
I mean, Saltaire beer is a lot better on cask because you get more of the fuller flavour. Whereas, like I said, the Dats there are more refined flavour because the choose the ingredients more finely, so a lot of the flavour comes out better on bottle. And just like the Marble Earl Grey IPA and just like the Wild River, it's a lot better on bottle.
It's really nice though, isn't it?
Every time I see this, I always envision River Wild from Meryl Streep and Kevin Bacon. For the simple reason, it's just a alternate words.
Yeah.
But great film as well. I mean, it has the same symbolism as well. It also has, if you look at the image from Wild River, it's very similar to the...
Yeah.
But great film, great beer on bottle of a cask.
Yeah.
And new logo on the caps. You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Oh, wait. Shit. Would you buy it again? Yeah. Bottle.
Yeah.
Bye.